There'll also be information on how to apply to take part in the second series. That's Big Brother Night, Saturday from 9:05 on 4.
Now on 4, it's finger licking good. It's the Big Breakfast.
Cold and refreshing.
Oh, I'm so hot.
Welcome to the Big Breakfast. It's Friday the 22nd of December. I'm Johnny Vaughan. Good morning to you.
Oh, and lovely. I'm the very hot and sweaty Denise Van Outen.
You're really minging.
Really
this morning
minging.
Over there. The ming. Oh. And though there are only 3 days to go till Christmas, we're here in the garden enjoying the gorgeous summer weather.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Now, if you think that's crazy, then meet the man who barbecues his turkey every Christmas. It's barbecue expert Roger Barrett.
The convected heat goes round and round.
Roger, you're not serious. Surely it takes ages.
Well, this has been going for a couple of hours.
Look at that. Roger, explain what's going on in there.
OK, well, let's put that down. We've got a 14-pound turkey.
Yeah, lovely. Feed about 8.
Yeah, well, yeah, according to the label, 12 to 14, but they don't need to look.
Smells good.
And we've got a drip tray under there, catching the juices, which you can use.
Where's the heat going, Roger?
And the heat, well, the charcoal's here, either side.
Yeah.
And it's convected heat, and you know all about that.
The convected heat goes round and round.
I can really smell the meat.
Oh, Roger. Anyway, while Roger's slaving away, we'll be finding out if his cooking's up to the challenge later in the show and enjoying a bit of barbecue turkey.
OK, here's what's coming up this morning. After the news, Mr. Vaughan there will be ripping into the morning's press to bring you the final paper review and pun of the week before Christmas.
Before Christmas, the final one. Then at 8:20, Richard Bacon continues his Highland fling with Madonna up in Dornoch.
Dornoch! And then at 8:30, we've got a whole bunch of stuff up for grabs in
bunch
our festive freebie competition. Actually, I'm really cold. Santa's stocking.
You're not going to say that. It's an illusion.
I'm picking up Channel 5.
You'll be the only one who does that. And we're joined in the house by star of Stella Street, one of my heroes. I've just been having a laugh with him in makeup.
If
you do bump into him, always say to him, I love your early stuff. He is Phil Cornwell, ladies and gentlemen.
Does my skin look battery?
And 50 lucky viewers will be getting the chance to win this year's most covetable toys, ladies and gentlemen. They're here. They're going to be in a special pen. Somewhere.
And
they're over the other side.
Of course, Friday.
Look at them. Look at them.
50 people out in the cold
all
morning.
Do you like the way I'm trying to stretch this out? Because I know you're a bit chilly.
I'm really cold.
Great tactics. Great tactics.
I don't want to move my clipboard.
Barbecue deck. It's lovely here. Go on, show them.
I'd like to put my arms around the meat to warm up.
I bet you would.
And it's Friday, so it wouldn't be the same without the Friday song.
And it's an absolutely normal show, so it wouldn't be the same without Jasmine Lowson with the Big Breakfast News and Weather.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of December. Security scare for Madonna, a great Christmas getaway, and 5 go to court in Dublin. They're doing it lock, stock and barrel today. Madonna and Guy get hitched in the Highlands, but not before baby Rocco managed to cause a commotion. Here's Simone Sutcliffe.
Yesterday's christening of baby Rocco was the perfect support act. Guy Ritchie and Madonna were joined by their showbiz pals Sting, Gwyneth Paltrow, Stella McCartney and Rupert Everett. And while our very own Richard Bacon tried to breach security, a 51-year-old man was arrested after being found inside Dornoch Cathedral during the service. Today's wedding at Skibo Castle is private. If it goes to plan, the world will get to see just one official photograph.
New Labour's hold on Scotland took another battering last night. Blair's man Eric Joyce won the Falkirk West by-election. But Labour's majority was slashed from 14,000 to just 705 by the SNP. The Great Christmas Getaway gets underway this afternoon, but be prepared for major delays. On the railways, the GNER East Coast Main Line is only running at 40%, while Virgin is providing 80% of their Christmas service. Traffic chaos is expected at major hotspots, including the M25 at the M3 and M4 junctions. Airlines are also urging passengers to leave plenty of time to check in. Bikini Bop bad boys Richie Neville and Jason Brown of Five have been remanded on bail following a pub brawl in Dublin. They were charged with public disorder and breaching the peace and will return to court on January the 10th. Here's the sport. Football terraces could make a comeback. Sports Minister Kate Hoey has gone against government policy to consider a return to standing at matches. Stadiums went all-seater after the Hillsborough disaster in 1989, which left 96 Liverpool fans dead. Transfer frenzy continues with Titi Camara joining West Ham. Chelsea haven't offered enough yet for Robbie Fowler, but Fulham could easily stump up enough for Barcelona's Emmanuel Petit. Mohamed Fayad's first division outfit have offered £8 million so far. That's the Big Breakfast News. Simon's at the house with the weather.
Well, thanks very much, Jasmine Lowsom. It's Christmas, isn't it? It's a Friday and it's Christmas. So if it helps you at all, think of me as a kind of James Bond film. Not Never Say Never Again, though. That's not a real one. Dry and cold then today, with a few bright spells in the west. This morning, though, eastern Britain will have a great murky morning, I'm afraid, with fog on some of the hills and, a bit of my favourite word, drizzle in some parts. In western and southern districts, though, you might see a few brighter spells here and there after a bit of a misty start. Indeed, here it's still a little bit misty. And we'll all have a little chilly easterly wind that we've had all week, keeping it feeling a little bit nippy. This afternoon, still mostly dry, but still rather cold. Cloudy in the east, a little bit brighter in the west. Southwest England might catch a few splashes of rain later this afternoon, I'm afraid. And northern Scotland might also have a few showers, and they may even include a bit of the old sleet there. A quick look at today's temperatures then. A 6 in Aberdeen, a 7 in Belfast, 7 also in Wales, a 5 for the Midlands, 7 here in London, and an 8 in the southwest. That's all from me. I'll be back in half an hour to tell you about your Christmas weekend. But for now, back inside with Johnny and Denise.
You're right, Dan.
I'm good this
morning.
This
is very pretty,
isn't it?
Thank
you.
Is that your own customised touch? I hope it is.
No, it's Topshop.
Is it Topshop? Mm. Well done to Topshop. John, I can hear a cry, ladies and gentlemen.
Read all about this! Read all about this!
Thank you to the papers. Kriggy is holding The Guardian. Hamilton protests as he loses the last battle. I don't know why it is. I don't know if it, you know, what is it? The enemies of your friends' enemies are your friends or something. But I started to really get pro-fired in all this because I don't particularly care for the Hamiltons. Anyway, ex-Tory MP Neil Hamilton faces financial ruin after his libel case appeal collapses. Just because someone's down on their luck doesn't mean they're a good person. never forget that. Often we think just because someone seems to be a victim suddenly, they're suddenly morally upright. Yeah. Not quite the case. Daily Mail, let's move on. Charles, my fears over
who's
the Euro.
Who's that?
Where?
Bob the
it's
Builder.
Bob the Builder, ladies and gentlemen. Yay! I don't know if oh, that's the obvious question, isn't it? But I don't think.
Can you fix it?
Can you fix
yes,
it?
Yes, you can.
Can you fix it, Bob?
Can I fix it?
Okay. my fears over the... It's not much of an act, really, is it? Okay, my fears over the Euro Army. Prince Charles is afraid the Euro Army will undermine the special relationship between Britain and the US. And, of course, untypically, he's absolutely right. Let's move through to The Sun. A bunny wee lad. This is a headline pun, which is nice to see. Madonna and Guy Ritchie's son, Rocco, gets christened wearing a bunny outfit. Bunny. Bunny. It's topical. It's good. Good front page. Sure, I think I'm going to get in there, ladies and gentlemen. There's always more fun to be had. First of all, Mensa burglar left a trail to his own front door. A Mensa member who burgled a neighbour's house. I love the super intelligent society turned to crime like a kind of Lex Luthor. a Mensa member who burgled a neighbour's house was caught after he left a trail of footsteps right back to his own front door. Stephen Pace, 26, he's got an IQ of 150. He stole jewellery worth $6,500 in the raid. But he gave the game away by carrying out the break-in during a torrential rainstorm and trudging mud through his victim's house. Police followed his muddy footprints from the scene of the crime to his home 35 yards away. If he is sent to prison, it could crush a very talented and clever person. This is what his defence said. He's gone off the rails, but he deserves another chance. The court heard he's got previous convictions for shoplifting and burglary. but what I love about this is it finishes with one of those classic police quotes that make life worth living. He says, he may be a member of Mensa on paper, but he's a member of Densa at crime. Evil, bit of a joke, just talking to you in there.
And I think I cracked a bit of a joke. You waiting reporter. Michael Douglas pays £1 million to a golf aide who was hit in the Goulis. Superstar Michael Douglas coughed up around £1 million to a golf caddy who claimed the actor smashed a ball into his privates. That's gotta hurt. Course assistant. How fast does a golf ball go when it hits the club? It's about 208 miles an hour, isn't it? Something like 208 miles an hour.
Isn't that a risk you'd take on the golf course?
Sorry, Donna?
Isn't that a risk you'd take being on a golf course?
Well, you'd have thought so, yes.
Why do you have to pay $1 million?
Yeah, comes with the turf, I'd say. Go caddying with a man, expect to lose your nats. Sure he appreciates your sympathy. Course assistant James Parker's left testicle is the left one. Statistically hangs lower.
Does it?
Statistically, yeah. Yeah, for right-handed people, I think.
You're fine.
Yeah, fine, thanks. And it's been removed by doctors.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. Mr. Parker launched a bid to sue Golf Mad Michael, claiming an amazing £70 million in damages. It's a cruel twist of fate to be robbed of your manhood by a sex addict. Yeah. Is it not?
A former sex addict.
Former sex addict ruins my sex life by taking my nad. But what
we
it was
could sit on top of the Christmas tree.
there's a great little account here. I don't know if it might be hogwash, but he says here the black caddy alleged the star simply shoved around £40 in his shirt pocket as he lay in agony, then walked off muttering a racist remark. Shocking. Okay, this is from the Reverend Alan Wright in Barton-on-Humber, Lincolnshire. He writes to the Daily Telegraph today, "Sir, surely every schoolboy or schoolgirl knows the difference between snowmen and snow women. Snowballs."
Hey!
Thank you to the Reverend Alan Wright. Do you know, I enjoy very much how awful the royal family are to each other. It's something that over the years you can enjoy their absolute coldness, unreasonable, their dysfunctionality.
This is a story, let me guess, about Fergie?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Excluding the Duchess of York from the royal family's Christmas Day celebrations is, quote, deplorable and inhuman. Her father, Major Ron Ferg, said yesterday, Sarah will spend Christmas Day at Wood Farm on the Queen's Sandringham estate while Prince Andrew and their daughters join the royals for lunch at the Big House. It's a ridiculous situation, said Matt. That's so rude. Marvellous. Tucking in, knowing that all alone in Wood Farm is Fergie. There's her daughters and her husband. And you know what Philip would like to do is an after-lunch treat as well. Hunt Fergie in Woods. Just send her out. Fergie in court shoes is running through the literature. Where are you? Just striding through.
No, they should all move
in. Just a few pranks.
They should go to Adam's Rib.
They should go to Adam's Rib. Traders have joined forces in the Midlands to post a rogues gallery of shoplifters on the internet. I'd love to see a shoplifting hall of fame. Dave Fingersmith. Just load of people in really massive coats. Huge, bulky coats. Big bags like that with their arms over them. Shoplifting hall of fame. My dad walked in as I was having sex with my girlfriend. That's in The Times. Sorry, The Star. My dad walked in as I was having sex with my chick. The most embarrassing thing is my dad walked in, stopped, looked at us and said, "Tea's nearly ready."
One lump or
That's
two.
That's so British. Doesn't make you proud to be British, that kind of reaction. To which we both replied, "OK." Without moving, they stayed, whatever, locked.
OK.
And then he says, the problem is now is my girlfriend's finding it really embarrassing when she comes around the house. She says, my girlfriend's refusing to come around to my house while there's still an atmosphere. Swaziland needs a state executioner. Any volunteers? Linton. I can see you as an executioner.
Yeah.
Not being funny, but I can actually see you quite enjoying that.
Sure.
They don't do many. They've got their new king was educated in English public school, so work for executioners is hen's tooth scares. Would you fancy that, do you think?
Yeah,
Gordon Lever?
Yeah,
I love it. Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Really broad-minded
guy. Could
be fun job. Yeah, why not? I'd kill people, yeah. I swear. Steps fans. Interesting story if you're here, Denise.
Mm-hmm.
Dozens of fans were locked in a freezing railway station after a Steps pop concert. Steps fans. locked in. Imagine, look, they've just been to a gig. It says here they're on the way home. And you're thinking, what, do they all live together? Like big, it's kind of Steps commune. You think, imagine, they've just been to a gig, and at first, I bet they're all, and now you're suddenly...
And then they have to do that just to keep warm. One more time.
Keep going. I can't run out of lyrics. I truly wanted on one album.
Suddenly Claire can't feel her nose.
Last thing here, letter from Lester. I take great exception... Oh, do the nose thing, how she... Claire does it. Oh, Steps. Good. She's got a case of Steps nose. Actually, my daughter Tabitha's been doing that when she smiles at me, yeah. Hope she doesn't grow up to be a Step.
You're always singing Steps to her.
She does that a bit as well. Okay. Come to think of it, goes like that. Yeah, quite disturbing.
Does she wear Lycra?
Not yet, no. But shh, she doesn't know what she's getting for Christmas. I take great exception.
It says
here, this is a letter to The Guardian. I take great exception to your description of Leicester as a dull English town. Leicester is a city.
Thank you very much indeed. Thanks for the viewers. Ladies and gentlemen.
Friday?
Yes, Friday. Pun down. It's the last pun down of the year, really. Next week, as you know, we've got the full, the pun down of the year, but this is the pun of the million. Pun in a million.
Yes. Wow.
Which actually, I've got to tell you, we got very excited about filming those, didn't we?
Windy Pops.
Bit of Windy Pops, I don't think anyone noticed it. Yeah. Mirror. Second-hand car dealers could go out of business as motorists stick to new vehicles. Good. Pun says, bangers and crash.
That's a good one.
It's not too bad. Number two. Star. Thursday. Someone calls out the RSPCA after mistaking a cuddly toy in a washing line for a cat in distress. We had this pun yesterday, the pun he said. Tabby or not tabby? That's good. And the winner. It's from today's Sun. Let's be outstanding. Yes. Hello there, how are you? You haven't stopped dancing yet.
Okay, feet don't feel me now. Where is the pun?
It's coming now.
Gosh.
Oh!
I say, Vicky's changed. Vicky.
Vicky's here today in casuals.
An outfit she bought down the Roman road.
Do you know what? Do you know what? In a certain advert I do, yeah, this man is inside the gorilla outfit with
Are
the
you?
Peanuts on his head to the left.
I know the advert. I know which one you mean.
The peanuts
is that you?
On his head.
So you know each other then?
Yeah, we know. We've worked together.
Fantastic.
We're mates. We're muckers.
Okay.
Horrid in that suit though, wasn't it? Really claustro.
Yep.
And you were singing, weren't you?
Something like that.
Yeah. Go on, sing that offensive song you were singing.
No. No.
Go on.
About, don't encourage
go on, what about the mayor of Drinkwater?
No!
OK, Madonna and Guy Ritchie have their son christened near Christmas, and all the guests are happy. Go away. Just get back in. Okay. Do you want to reveal the pun of the week?
Come on, you
go
can
on,
do it.
Go on, the last one of the year. Go on, what's your name?
Ben.
It's Ben?
Ben.
Do you really want to do this, Ben?
Yeah.
How
come
much?
On then, Ben.
A lot. OK, here we go. The party say, Merry Christmas!
Yay! Thank you very much indeed, Ben. Did you enjoy that?
Yeah!
You got the Ben. Ben, for the rest of the day, you shall wear the Cape of Pundum. Ben, Pun Prince.
Yay!
Our Ben, Pun Prince. But he is the chosen.
You need to parade the room now.
Parade, parade, Ben, parade, Ben. Parade him. There he is. Good stuff, Lenny. Do you know what?
Fantastic.
We're going to take a break now, right now. Why spend
all your money on Christmas presents when you can win all of them for free here at the Big Breakfast?
Yes.
Have a look at this.
Yes!
Play our competition, Santa's stockings, and you could win a sack full of Christmas presents, courtesy of Debenhams. For your chance of winning, just answer the following question. Father Christmas traditionally works in A, a grotto, B, a ghetto, or C, a gatto. And call 0900-144-7744 with your answer.
I'm a snowman.
Detox presents Facts of Life. Fact: to a child, any food can be fast food. Fact, cats don't pause to wipe their feet. Fact, Detox wipes safely kill harmful bacteria such as Salmonella and E. coli, and are bleach-free and leave no taint or odour. Fact, teaching kids can be hit or miss. Life demands Detox. That's a fact.
Hey, don't crease me.
What's the problem?
If only it was less creased.
I can wear mine. Straight from the line.
I'll stay put, so they won't see the creases.
Creases? What creases?
New Downy Fabric Enhancer has a clear complex. Unlike softeners, which leave a coating on fibres, New Downy penetrates and smooths fibres from within. For less creases. Not just after the wash, but all the time you wear them. Downy. My clothes. Only better.
Very last TFI Friday, hosted by Elton John, tonight at 9:30 on 4.
Hello there, good morning and welcome to this Christmassy Friday. It's fantastic, isn't it? I'm Donna Eyre, this is The Bourne Bunker, and we're joined by the winner of Big Brother, Craig Phillips. Good morning. Now, I don't often turn down the chance to kiss a hunky man, but I've got flu. But we'll leave it at that. But it's lovely to have you here,
Thank
Craig.
You.
Now, Craig, as you know, has launched a charity single at this time of year with the dream of becoming the Christmas one. Number one, but last week, unfortunately, the track went in at a bit of a disappointing 14.
Number 14, yeah.
Is that right? So, Craig, how do you feel about losing out to, like, the likes of Westlife and Bob the Builder?
I mean, Westlife are a brilliant band, I did expect it, but Bob the Builder
Are you
is
a
Bob
Westlife
the Builder,
fan,
isn't he?
Are you?
Yeah, they're nice guys.
Have you hung out with them?
I've gone for a few drinks with them, yeah.
Have you? So you're getting all showbiz on us now, Craig. Where did you go with Westlife, then?
I can't remember now, some after parties.
What were they like?
They're all good lads, yeah. Yeah. Great lads, yeah. Seen them last week.
All right, okay. Well, anyway, Craig, here at The Breakfast, we do love a good charity case. Mm. Not that much, though. We're not going to play it. We don't want the ratings to go down. I'm only joking.
Thanks a lot.
I'm only joking. But we do want to help you out.
Yep, okay.
And we do want everybody to buy this single.
It's thousands of children.
Exactly.
Thousands
I'm with you. I think it's for a very good cause. Yep. So if anybody out there is in two minds this morning about whether to buy Craig's single, then we recommend you do so by doing that. You can call in and talk to Craig and you can put them on the right track, isn't that right?
Oh, certainly.
The number is 0208985 all the ones. Or you can fax us on 0208985 all the twos. Or you can email me at thebigbreakfast@channel4.com. So do keep those calls coming in. Also, you could maybe give your Christmas wishes to anybody, birthday dedications, and also maybe you could sing a little song to Craig.
Yep,
that would be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
All right, anyway, we're going to have a little look now because Richard Bacon's back on the road. He's up there in Scotland. Actually, he's over here. Richard! What's he doing now? Thanks. Richard!
Thanks very much, Donna.
Richard!
Thank you. Stop now! Stop! Thanks. I mean, it was lovely, don't get me wrong, but that's enough for now. Let me just get your names, hang on, it's rude not to. Thank you very much to the clan and drummer with a flavour of Scotland. I'm also wearing a kilt today. This is the exact kilt that Guy Ritchie will be wearing at his wedding later. We're back at the cathedral, as you can see this morning. We're not actually at Skibo Castle where they're getting married. A lot of more naive crews have gone there, but I can tell you they'll see nothing. The castle is set in like 4,000 acres of ground. So we're here, a lot of people coming down to see us. I know I've only got a few seconds left, but we've got some more music. And this is somehow more appropriate. It's more bagpiping, but Spud Fraser is now going to play for us Like a Virgin. Okay, he's gone. Right, anyway, join us later. Lots of exclusive, lots of chat, lots of people coming down to see us. So, more to come in Door Knock. For now, back to the house.
Yes! Hello, I'm Television's Johnny Vaughan.
And I'm Denise Van... Outen.
And this is our Christmas weekend, Route to Midnight.
This is our Christmas gift to you, the viewers.
There's an hysterical tour de force with Jennifer Saunders, Joanna Lumley and Julia Sawala in a brand new comedy set in the world of the theatre.
Yes, it's guaranteed to bring the house down.
Is that you, Han?
Yeah.
My range has gone. Did you hear? I don't know what's happened.
God, was that you? You used to have a good range, didn't you?
Yeah, more than three notes, wasn't it?
Yeah!
But hey, listen, how are you? Nervous?
Oh, Frieda's here. She's going to do my pieces with me.
Oh, then I'd better come up. She'll be no use. She's only an actress. She's not an entertainer.
There is nothing wrong with that piano, sir.
Send it a bit out to me, Bryce.
Oh, you're there, are you?
Good morning, Vivienne. Oh.
So watch Mirrorball, 9 o'clock, BBC One, on Friday.
It's ab-fab.
No, it's not, sweetie.
No, I know it's not ab-fab. It's a clever television reference.
OK, moving swiftly along, if you enjoyed Russell Crowe in Gladiator...
And I know I certainly did.
Then between you and me, I'll be watching him and Guy Pearce in the classic police thriller on BBC Two at 9:05 on Saturday. It's LA Confidential. I'll look
Great.
Forward to that.
Pierce Patchett made you, didn't he? Taught you how to dress, talk, and think. And I am very impressed with the results. But I need some answers. And if I don't get them, I'm going to take you and Patchett down.
Pierce Patchett can take care of himself. And I'm not afraid of you.
But don't tell everyone, or they'll all want to watch it.
And on Christmas Eve, when we finish distributing presents to the orphans...
And roasting my nuts. For my vegetarian nut roast Christmas dinner.
We'll all be enjoying the wonderful Will Smith.
Our close showbiz pal.
By watching him fighting the aliens in Independence Day.
We're fighting for our right to live. To exist. And should we win the day, the 4th of July will no longer be known as an American holiday, but as the day when the world declared in one voice, we will not go quietly into the night. We will not vanish without a fight. We're going to live on. We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our Independence Day.
Will Smith stars in Independence Day. So show solidarity with us by watching our televisual feast, which we like to call
Johnny and Denise's Route to Midnight. Why not join us after the break when one lucky winner could win all their Christmas presents in one go in our competition, Santa's Stockings.
But now, here's my favourite programme.
And mine.
The Adverts. So, it looks like rain, deer. Do you get it? Because what I've done there is rain, deer. It's like reindeer. Yeah. Reindeer. It's a cracker. Do you get it? Cracker.
He's a powerful man, a rich man, a single man. But fate is about to show him the man he could have been.
Come on!
This isn't my house. Ugh. You're not my wife.
What?
Nicolas Cage.
I'm not a dad. Oh.
The Family Man.
Who are you?
My name's Bond.
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 James Bond.
This Christmas at Virgin Megastores, grab a copy of The World Is Not Enough on VHS for $12.99 and get another...
Bond.
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 VHS absolutely free. Who knows? It could inject a bit of action into your life. The World Is Not Enough, out now at Virgin Megastores. Whatever turns you on.
We all like to make more calls at Christmas, and with this Vodafone Mobile on SmartStep, that's not a problem, because the more you use it, the less you pay. That's common sense.
It's your colonel coming at you.
Hey, now let me show you something special. My new crispy popcorn chicken. Real tender chicken with a crispy coating in handy bite-sized pieces. Hey, how's that for finger-licking chicken you can pop in your mouth? Slam dunk some today. All you gotta do is shoot on down to KFC. Don't forget to check out my new website.
I turn to you. Let Melanie C's Northern Star light up your life. Featuring the number one smash hit, I Turn to You, and Never Be the Same Again. Plus the brand new single, If That Were Me. Melanie C, Northern Star, shining brightly.
I'm here to scientifically prove that E4, the new entertainment channel from Channel 4, is scientifically better than the other rubbish on digital TV.
Well-bred, lovely. Oh, look at the breeding of her. Creamy skin and thick hair and outdoor sport and custard with everything. Custard and sponge after every meal. And a hymn and a prayer before bed, lovely.
OK, here's what's still to come on this morning's show.
Can I just say?
What?
Barry, 20 years in the Met.
Hey!
20 years! Man and boy. Barry, you spent 20 years in the Metropolitan Police. Is this a special time of year for you?
Yes, there's more people.
20 years in the Met! Lovely.
Cuff me, Barry.
Anyway, Santa's stocking, ladies and gentlemen, that's coming up at 8:45.
Richard Bacon's in the Highlands getting the lowdown on the Madonna wedding.
That's really spooky. At
8:45, it's time really to...
I was just doing the ironing. And I was just going over this shirt, and suddenly I just realised I was really turned on. At 8:45, Richard Bacon's in the Highlands getting the lowdown on the Madonna wedding. How about that? At 8:40, annoying toys, plus 50 desperate punters. Galaxy of Stars, Stash Street, Phil Cornwell, lots of things.
Where's
Jasmine
Phil?
Lowson, there they are, outside. Jasmine, news.
Does anybody else here suddenly feel really turned on?
I feel really turned on. Here's Jasmine.
What's wrong?
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of December. Big day for the big boys, last-minute shopping frenzy and the golden Brit flicks. There'll be a hefty security force out and about for today's private wedding of Madonna and Guy at Skibo Castle. But there were plenty of photo opportunities at yesterday's christening of baby Rocco. His was an impressive guest list. Sting, Gwyneth Paltrow and Stella McCartney were all there to help wet his head. Three men will be sentenced at Hull Crown Court today for a multi-million pound meat scam. Andrew Boyd has been convicted, along with Darren Bibby and Peter Tantrum, of conspiracy to defraud by selling rotten chicken and turkey destined for pet food as fit for human consumption. A man's due to appear in court later, charged with the murder of a policeman who was knocked down while carrying out speed checks. Constable John Adele died after being hit by a car and dragged 50 yards along a road at Margate in Kent. Christmas falling on a Monday, retailers are expecting a huge rush of people hitting the shops this weekend. So far, it's been quiet on the high streets, with turnovers lower than usual. Many stores will be staying open until 9 o'clock at night to catch last-minute buyers. Nominations for this year's Golden Globes have been announced. Billy Elliot and Gladiator are up for Best Picture, along with Erin Brockovich and new drug war film Traffic. Judi Dench, Julie Walters and Catherine Zeta-Jones are named in Best Actress or Supporting Actress categories. Here's the sport. The Christmas fairy has given Spurs fans their wish. Alan Sugar is history. Manager George Graham hopes new chairman Daniel Lever will be more ready with the checkbook. It's not clear what Graham's future will be now Sugar's gone. Brazilian man of mystery Ronaldo is back. The wizard, who's been riddled with injury problems since the World Cup, has kicked a ball in public for the first time in 8 months. The Inter Milan hero says he's finally beaten off knee problems and can return to his best. That's the Big Breakfast News. Simon's at the house with the weather.
Bye.
Thanks very much. Well, dry and cold for most of us today. A few bright spells in the west. This morning, though, eastern Britain will have a grey, murky start, I'm afraid. Might even see patches of fog over the high ground, so be careful if you're driving. And spots of drizzle here and there. In western and southern districts, though, might see a few brighter spells after a bit of a misty start, but it will feel rather cold thanks to this easterly wind blowing through the whole country. This afternoon, still mostly dry, still rather chilly. Cloudy in the east, a little bit brighter in the west. Southwest England might see a few drips of rain. Northern Scotland might see a bit of sleet or indeed showers. That's all from me. Now it's back inside.
Hello there.
Do you know what? We've got 50 people outside. They're waiting to take part in a big raffle later. Yeah.
We're leaving them out there all morning in the cold.
All morning. They're loving it, though.
Absolutely. Give them a wave.
Look at their faces. They're loving it. Look at your girl here. You can tell by her face, she's loving the excitement, yes? Look at the two blondes at your front with your guy. She's loving this action. Okay. Do you know what? It's time to play Santa's Stockings!
For it is time to play Santa's Stockings. Some of them have presents in, some of them are shocking.
Yes, indeed, Santa's Stockings, the game where you can win all your Christmas presents in one fell swoop.
21 stockings.
Four of them are shocking stockings, 17 contain possible prizes. Each of our three callers will be asked to pick a stocking. If they hear this noise, they've got a prize. If they hear this noise, that is a shocking stocking. You are out of the game. At the end of the game, the caller's got the most stockings without being knocked out, then has the chance to gamble. They can either press their buttons at home, in which case they'll hear this noise, or they can keep the prizes they've already had, in which case they'll hear this noise. If at the end of it none of them have won, we carry on with the tiebreak. I hope that's absolutely clear. Okay.
Sort of.
It sounds simple, but there
really
could be a lot
clear.
Of stake as we play Shocking Stocking.
Yes! Good.
I'm confused.
Let's meet the callers. First caller is Joanne from Cardiff.
Hello.
Morning, Joanne.
Hello, Joanne.
Morning.
Oh, you sound in the Christmas spirit of things.
I am.
You really
chirpy.
Cheery. We love that, don't we, Dan?
Hi, Joanne, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yeah,
and
great.
You?
Yeah, I'm good too. Yeah, not bad. Looking forward to Christmas, Joanne?
Yeah,
me too. Yeah. Is anyone else here looking forward to Christmas?
Yeah.
Have you done all your Christmas shopping yet, Joanne?
Yeah, sort of.
Would you like to do all
I'm
your.
I'm not just, interested.
Would you like to win lots of prizes?
Yes, I would.
Do you want to crack on and play the game, or should we not sort of,
Yeah, let's do it.
No, I'll tell you what, let's just do it anyway, yeah? Do you fancy that, Joanne?
Should we just do it anyway, Joanne,
yes,
even though there's no real point, is there?
Right. All right, go on then.
It's all right, because next week none of us are turning up, so it doesn't matter. Yeah.
Anyway, good luck, Joanne, you know. Yeah. You might win something, you might not,
you
don't know.
Yeah, you never know, you know, who cares anyway, it doesn't matter, does it?
Christmas.
Television,
who needs it, eh?
Go on, who cares?
Right.
Go on, Joanne, I suppose you've got to pick a stocking, so you may as well start.
Which one would you like to go for?
Number 17, please.
Yeah, number 17, I suppose that's quite a good one.
It's not like bad, really. Number. Go on,
yeah, 17, it's all right.
Shall we open it or just not
sometimes
bother?
Sometimes it's lucky, sometimes it's not.
Do we need to know? I don't think we particularly do. Go on.
Oh, I don't know if I should.
Oh, go on, then.
I'll go on, then.
Yay! I'm sure she's delighted, really.
Hey, Joanne, you've won a prize. You want to know what you've won?
Yes, please.
Go on, then, let's have a look. Go on.
Oh,
yes. Set of cuddly toys.
Oh. Come on, mix these in quicker.
Joanne, are you happy with that?
Oh, yeah, great.
Yeah, that's good, yeah.
Great. Wow, you pulled out the great word. God, you're making the effort.
Right, pick another one. Do you want to stick or play on?
Play on, please.
Play on,
go on,
okay, that's more interesting. Yeah. This is building, I'm warming to this game.
Okay, go on,
she's
pick
just
a number.
Cool.
Number three, please.
Here we go.
Okay, 16 stockings, four shockers
that's
still in there. 16
there, okay.
to four the odds.
Close
4
up.
To 1 now, 4 to 1. You're going to get a shocking stocking. No, those odds slash. Here's what you won. Complete set of lingerie.
Have a look, and it looks something like this.
No, it doesn't. That's obscene. Okay, let's carry
a complete
on.
Set of lingerie.
There we go. I'm just going to check. So, are you going to play those in, or do you want us to announce each one? You're really late, you leave us faffing. What do you want to do, Control?
I want to play on, please.
Not you, I was
not
talking about the producer.
You just
play.
You just chill.
Okay, all I can say to you, listen, just drop the VTs, I'll do it myself, all right?
Okay, come on, let's just crack on. Would you like
Thanks,
to play
Dan.
On, or do you want to stick with the two prizes you've won? The cuddly
I'll play
toys
on,
and
please.
You play on, okay.
Okay, good choice. Which number?
Who are you talking
16,
to now, the producer
please.
Or her?
No,
okay,
I'm
16.
Talking to Joanne.
Okay.
My mate, all right?
16, please.
Go on.
Okay, 16. Where is it? Over here. Good luck, Joanne. All right, Matt, got this.
Do no point to that, was
Joanna, there? You got it.
Sorry. Well, not really.
Yeah, sort of
not really,
really
no. It doesn't matter,
does
it?
Have a nice Christmas.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, Joanne. Thank you for lighting up our lives.
OK.
OK, let's go to Nassim in High Wycombe. Morning, Nassim. How are you this morning?
Fine.
Don't mess around with us, Nassim. Seriously. There's plenty more callers. There's 50 people out there
in
the cold.
Do you know how many calls we get, people wanting to play this game?
Denise, just shut up a second, Denise. Let me just explain something here, all right? We've got 50 people out there.
Oh, don't start having
a go at me. No, I am going to. They've been out there for 2 hours. You know why? Just to win Tracy Island. You got the chance to win 21 presents, and you're fine. You're just fine.
Now we're marvellous.
OK, now we're getting somewhere. Right, come on.
No,
I will get it, you. Go on, get the stockings. Nassim, where are you going to go?
Number five, please.
Number five. I can't get it off. Yay! The Times offset that.
OK, the prize. Never. I think that was the first, wasn't it? You've won a TV and video!
Lovely, thank you.
OK, do you want to play on or just stick with that?
I'll play on, please.
I'll stick, John. I'd like to stick, Johnny.
No, play
okay,
on.
OK, here we go. Play on. Where are you going to go?
Number 13.
Number 13.
I'm lucky for some.
It's all right, it's OK. She's won a prize. Men's designer wear. Men's designer wear. OK, you've got two on. You're obviously the leader at the moment. Where do you want to go?
Oh, I don't want Ben.
What?
Where do you want to go?
Number nine, please.
Number nine. Number nine?
Number nine.
I don't want Ben. Oh, my bad. Oh, yeah. Yes, star prize. What number was that again?
Number nine.
Number nine, you've won two designer leather jackets. Whoa. That's your third prize, I believe. Do you want to play on or
really
stick?
They're really nice. Fat wings.
Play on or stick. Remember, you could gamble all these and win 17 prizes. What are you going to do?
Go on, please.
You're going to go on. Okay. Where are you
always
gonna go?
This keen?
Yeah.
Where are you
okay,
going to go,
Nash?
Can I have 19?
Number 19.
You certainly can. My lovely, my pretty, my sweet, my gorgeous.
19. No, 19.
Yes! Ladies' nightdress and matching gown. Oh,
wow. Just okay. Don't light your cigarette
listen,
when you're wearing
Nassim,
it.
Listen, do you know what I think? Are you going to stick?
Oh, I don't know. What do you reckon?
Well, I'd kind of stick there, because Andrew's got to now beat that four to go on. And I can tell you now, there's... Oh, how many prizes have gone? There's your four plus Joanna two, didn't she?
Yes.
So that's six prizes gone out of 17. That means there's 11 prizes still up there and three shocking stockings. So odds of 11 to three there. It's less than four to one.
This is all up to you. It's up to you if you want to stick or play on.
You're going
to
stick.
You're going to stick.
I think that's probably
right,
pretty
right,
let's
wise. Go to line three, then. We've got Andrew
it's
from
your
Lee.
Decision, though. I can't make that decision for you.
I think she's made her decision.
OK. I think she has.
I think she has, John, and I want to meet Andrew.
Oh, let's meet Andrew.
Good morning, Andrew.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Hello. I'm brilliant.
It's all right, you get...
On TV.
You get these from time to time. You get hello people, we call them. Hello. Are you all right, mate?
Hello.
Are you all right?
Yes, I'm smashing.
Good.
Yes, brilliant.
It sounds like someone we can do business
with. Are you
looking
forward to Christmas?
Oh, I am, yes.
Good. OK, well, best of luck to you.
Do you love Christmas?
Sorry?
Do you love Christmas, all the food and booze?
Yes.
And birds?
Do you like that?
Oh, it's best time of year, because you don't go to work.
OK, let's play the game.
OK.
Pick a stocking, any stocking.
Sounds to me like another university student on the line here. Come on, carry on.
Number 8.
Number 8.
Andrew. OK, good luck to you.
OK, number 8.
Okay. Yay!
A complete set of costume jewellery.
Oh, wow!
OK. God, do you know what? I've just realised. Any day now, they're going to be starting, aren't they? The sale ads!
Yes.
Nothing to pay ever. No money now. Ever. Nothing ever. Take it now, never pay ever. Buy it or we burn it. OK, Andrew, where do you want to go? I'm going to put a stocking up for you. Where do you want to go?
15, please.
15.
15, down the corner there. Den after 14.
Yay! Yay!
Ladies designer bodywear.
It's a dream.
Andrew, that's another stocking up there. Where else do you want to go, mate? You've got to beat the four, or else there's no point.
22.
There is no 22. I see what you've done.
I think he means my stocking.
Yeah, he certainly does.
Number 12. Number
12.
Goodbye, Andrew.
Oh.
It's sad, actually, because you're our most enthusiastic caller, and you haven't won. And that's sad, because I'd love you to win. But I can't rig it. That's that done. Now we return to Nazim in High Wycombe.
Good morning, Naz.
Morning.
Naz, I can tell you now, two shocking stockings have gone, which means there are still two lurking in there. I think we've lost, what, we got 11 minus two. There's nine prizes there. There's nine. It's 9-2 the odds. 4.5-1. Where are you going to go?
Stick with the prizes.
What do you want to do? Do you want
to
gamble?
No, I'm going to go for it, Christmas.
Are you going to gamble or stick to the prizes you've won?
Gamble!
Crew, what do you think?
Gamble!
I suggest you gamble.
Ed, hang on.
Gamble.
You can ask Ed, our producer, if you like. Ed, our producer, Ed, what would you do in this situation?
Stick.
Do you know what? You've turned into such a wimp. When I first came to this show, you'd have gambled that all the way. Even if there's only two left, you'd have gambled. And I was like, ooh, I'm a family man. I'll go safe. I'll go safe. Ooh, because I've got a 4x4 car. Ooh.
Ed, it makes me mad, Ed.
He has lost his bottle a bit, though.
He has lost his bottle, yeah. He's definitely bald. Anyone will tell you that. Fans of The Big Breakfast would say Ed's lost his bottle. Yeah. Where
so
do you want to go?
What
are you going to gamble?
I'm
going to
gamble.
Yeah.
Come on.
Write to Ed at Safe Street. Yeah. Secure house. Safe Street. No Riskville.
Family man. Yeah. Look at Ed's face.
Okay. Look at Ed's face.
He hates me.
Okay, where do you want to go, Naz? This is it, the big moment.
Good luck.
I'll go to number 10, please.
Okay.
Okay, go for number 10.
Good luck.
I think you're going to be, we'll see.
I'm going to blow on it because
I think
means
perhaps
it will
Ed,
be
our leader,
box.
Might actually be laughing at us all because, bad news, lady. Yeah! You've won a Michelin scooter, kitchen accessories, a complete set of lingerie,
children's sizes,
TV and video,
designer bed linen,
complete set of costume jewellery,
two designer leather jackets,
complete set of glasses,
selection of children's toys,
men's designer wear,
complete home beauty salon with foot spa and bath spa,
latest designer partywear,
set of cuddly toys,
complete Christmas dinner service,
ladies' nightdress and matching gown,
CD Walkman, digital clock and pocket PC with nothing to pay, not ever now because you've won it.
Yeah!
There's a moral here.
Eddie.
Ladies and gentlemen, a winner in Nazim.
Yay! We'll be meeting a hopeful for the Christmas number one. Meanwhile, this is The Big Breakfast, home of the hits.
Is it?
For you. I spy with my little eye something beginning with T.
Turkey.
Wow, you got it right again. You guys are really
right,
good.
That's it, Johnny. Well, you hold her down and I'll pull her wings off.
Jenny,
go on, Johnny, get her!
Okay.
Get her!
From the writer and director of The Sixth Sense.
It has begun.
Most of David Dunn's life has been full of mystery. Now he's about to experience a new reality.
Why are you looking at me like that?
One, because it seems you are the only survivor. And two, because you didn't break one bone. You don't have a scratch on you.
Some people seek out their destiny.
I wanted to ask you a question. It's gonna sound a little strange, but just think about it for a second. Do you remember me ever getting sick?
I can't remember.
For others, fate finds them.
I've come to believe the rather unbelievable possibility. I hope you can keep an open mind.
You can't let bad things happen to good people, right?
Just an ordinary man.
No, you're not.
Bruce Willis. Samuel L. Jackson.
Are you ready for the truth?
Unbreakable.
I'm a sculptor.
I teach golf.
I work in the fashion department.
I'm a writer.
You're sensational.
Like it very much.
That's love. Inspiration. I like complicated women.
It smells great.
I feel sexy.
Absolutely.
I'm in love.
Want to marry me?
What a question.
I hate cameras. Well, until today. Where's my allure?
Allure from Chanel.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you. All right, Michael. Happy Christmas.
What's this?
It's a phone.
I wanted a Virgin Mobile.
A phone's a phone, darling.
Oh, please. I wanted cheap calls and no line rental. You get both with Virgin Mobile.
Calm down, Mike.
Calm down.
Michael.
That's how I feel inside.
Spoil someone rotten. Call 0845 6000 750 for our new brochure.
Good morning and welcome back to the Farm Bunker on this lovely Christmas Friday! Yay! All right, Craig, how are you doing?
I'm fine, thanks. We've got plenty of calls.
Yes, tell me what kind of advice then you've been giving to everybody.
Basically to go out and buy a song because it's for a great cause.
It is for a very good cause.
Go into the Down syndrome.
You could call in and talk to Craig because Craig is pleading with everybody out there to go and buy his single. And I'm going to go and buy it today.
We had one call from Sean and he says if you wish him happy Christmas, he'll buy 50 copies and send him over to Romania.
Really? Well,
Sean.
Happy Christmas, Sean. There you go, 50 singles sold.
Thank you.
Anything else?
Yes, we had Sharon from the cause phone up and asked me if your research has got any better.
You what?
you got me back.
Yeah, you got me back. Marvellous. Anything else?
We've had some lovely children from Lorna, she's 11, from Sheffield. She wants signed photographs and signed CDs.
Signed photographs, signed CDs.
Signed CDs, yes.
Marvellous. All right, well, do keep the calls coming in for Craig. He's pleading with everybody to go and buy his single. And maybe we could have a bit of singing on the show. That's what I feel like, a good old sing-song. Also, don't forget to keep your birthday requests coming in and all those Christmas messages. But do I detect... Oh, look, Richard's with a good old mate, Dominic Mohan. Richard, say hello to Dominic for us.
Oh, hello, Donna. Hello. Sorry, I was just having a little chat with somebody. Thanks very much. And I'm with Dominic from The Sun, the showbiz editor of The Sun. Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good to see you, Dom. Just let me explain. We're live in Dornoch again. We're outside the cathedral. That's where the christening was. You can see the door there. That's where Madonna went in. And these are some local musicians. Hello. We'll hear you later. Now, more naive crews, Dom, and I'm sure you'll back me up on this, have actually gone over to Skibo Castle this morning.
Yes.
But there's nothing to see there, is there?
No, and there's quite a lot to see here, isn't there? I think you're about 14 hours too late.
Yeah, I know. But we're making our own event. But the truth is, at Skibo, the castle's in like 40,000 acres of land or something, and you can't really see a thing.
It's the size of 7,600 Wembley stadiums, apparently.
Is it?
It is. Okay. I've done my research.
Okay.
But yeah, I mean, they're just standing outside a gate. I mean, you know, we've got vans clearing up here, we've got a bloke clearing the bins.
Well, so certainly, that's this is where it's happening.
This is the place to be.
Yeah, you're right. All right, lads. Right, nice to see you, and man with newspaper. Thanks.
Do some work.
Yeah, work. Okay, now, yes, to be honest, it could be argued that we are a little bit journalistically below par. Because if I'm honest, yesterday I slept through the christening. I think I'm possibly... Paul Maprisa, can you come in a sec? I think I'm possibly the only reporter to do that. That said, Paul here, you did actually make it down to the christening yourself.
Well, we were a bit late as well, but we did see them in action. We saw them coming out, and it was great.
Okay, thank you very much.
It's nice to be with such professionals.
Yes. Well, we need you. I kind of need you for exclusives, really. Can you give us any kind of stories, either about the christening or about tonight's wedding? Anything you've got will save me.
Well, we're told that the wedding's actually at noon, and that people are being asked to arrive at 10 o'clock, and there's haggis on the menu. That's an exclusive.
Is it?
Yeah, vegetarian haggis, obviously, for Sting.
Okay.
The
wedding's at 12 o'clock. So I thought
There's a rumour that it may be at 12. Some people are saying 6, but I think it's going to be at 12.
Okay, all right, thank you, Dominic. Can I show you as well? Yesterday, I want to show you where I was when the christening happened.
Okay.
I was asleep in, get this sound if you've got a woo, in my jacuzzi. I had a jacuzzi. It's only a one-berth jacuzzi, but I've got some footage. Have a look down there. Let's play it in now. I think you'll be able to see it. It should be bubbling. Can you see it there?
Yeah,
there
it's bubbling away.
What do you think of that?
That is absolute class.
It's beautiful.
Is that
isn't
very
it?
Similar to one Madonna's got in her suite?
I imagine hers is bigger.
But maybe to be honest, a little bit. Yeah.
I enjoyed that more than being here down at the christening. But yeah, Dominic, thank
it's
you.
It's a lot warmer.
Thank you. And also, Dave Hogan, who's your photographer, is taking a picture of us. Dave, just a quick word from you. You actually photographed Madonna at her first wedding, didn't you?
Yeah, it was a lot warmer than this one.
Yes.
It was in Malibu, it was sort of hot. And...
okay. So how did it go for you? Did you get a good shot yesterday?
Yeah, great shot. So, I mean, they played the game, waved, okay, showed the baby. That's all we wanted. No one's going to get anything today, picture-wise.
OK. All right, thanks very much, Dave. But also, this is something... I know that you got a good shot, but these two people here actually took... take a bow. You did very well. These two people here actually took some amateur footage. This is Mark and Talitha. You took what I think is the best footage I have seen of the christening. This is unbelievable. Dominic, come and have a look at this. You'll be impressed. Let's run the footage. There's our monitor. And this is your personal footage. So there we go, there's your camcorder. Nice zoom. And there she goes, she turns, you get a good smile, and there's Guy heading in as well. And they disappear. Bit more zooming in and out. And there she turns and waves. She's almost, I mean, what you've got there, she's almost looking down the barrel, isn't she? Do you know what I mean? That's a dream, isn't it, for any sort of cameraman
or
photographer.
I like the sort of grainy Jeremy Beadle sort of feel about it as well.
It is. Right.
I think this guy, but you'd be after his job.
Yeah, yeah.
Give her a job immediately.
Our cameraman could do with taking some notes from that. Can I say to you two, thank you very much for sharing your footage with us. Listen, we're going to be back later, lots more happening. Well, shall we just hear? Let's hear from our band here, just for a few seconds anyway. And that's it! Stop! Thanks very much. No, seriously, we just wanted a flavour. Thank you very much. Right, more later, live in Dornoch. Meanwhile, this is Channel 4, you're watching The Big Breakfast, and here is a break.
Anyone?
Oh, very funny, Denise. Very funny.
It's an outfit.
This Christmas at Virgin Megastores, grab a copy of the Coldplay album, Parachutes. Voted best album at this year's Q Awards. It makes the perfect present to yourself.
Oh, thank you very much.
Parachutes is out now at Virgin Megastores. Whatever turns you on.
So what are you going to cook?
Have a laugh, I'm always cooking. Why don't you cook for a change?
Oh, I hate cooking.
Here, look, let's toss for it. Heads or tails?
Tails.
Can you get the door, sweet?
Christmas.
I'm not having much luck so far.
Happy Christmas. Can I give you a hand?
Everything is perfect in here.
Oh.
I've got a present for you.
Oh, no, you have a book. Oh,
nice. You got the receipt.
You don't need to be a great cook to have a great Christmas with Sainsbury's.
There's a new kind of Nurofen, one you can take anywhere without water. For effective relief at the site of pain, new Nurofen mouthlets.
The album. Available at Andy's Records, where music matters.
We were going to do a taste test with another leading stimulation drink, but three flavours against one. It just ain't fair, is it?
Take good care of my baby. Now don't you ever make her cry. Just let your love surround her.
SMA comes in sachets, tins, and ready-to-use cartons to help you take good care of your baby.
Happy Christmas, Joseph. I've had the baby.
Good. Now let us give him a present. After all, it is Christmas.
But, Joseph, we can't afford any presents. Our Ed Master said we've already done all our money putting on this show.
Never mind. Look, here comes a crowd of shepherds with their flocks. Maybe they will help.
I am a crowd of shepherds with my flocks. Maybe I will can help.
Hop along on my bouncy legs. I'm the Easter bunny that brings
Donna,
you
Donna, it's
up.
Christmas!
It's not Easter!
We are the three wise men.
What have you brought us?
Some gifts.
Oh, a gift worth its weight in gold. After the news, we've got Stella Street's Phil Cornwell with his celebrity mates.
Oh! Oh!
Smell it.
Mind, I can't see the script.
Smell.
Move it.
Smell of frankincense.
Oh! The smell of frankincense. Richard Bacon has been cordially invited to witness the wedding of Madonna and Guy, albeit from a huge, long distance.
And there's Myrrh.
Myrrh?
The three most sought-after toys of the decade and the 50 supplicants. Only one blessed person will be chosen to receive these gifts.
Oh, look, Joseph, a wandering star.
It is Craig from Big Brother.
There's plenty of room at the end. Now I've voted them all out.
And here comes the last wise man. Why? It's Jimmy Hill.
Yes. You know, I wouldn't pick Dennis Wise to deliver a gift to the infant Jesus.
It's Phil Cornwell. Oh!
Star of Stella Street.
Yes.
Brilliant.
Phil can be the rest of the cast.
Yes.
Look, here come the shepherds. Tommy Cooper.
Fearless.
Sir Michael Caine.
No, I don't do shepherds. I bleed and told you.
Jack Nicholson.
How about a little bit of myrrh?
Robert De Niro.
What are you doing? I got a load of frankincense.
Mick Jagger.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
It's really cold here. Yeah.
Jules Holland.
Welcome to Christmas. And ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ray Charles. Hey,
and Keith Richards.
I don't know what time of year it is. You know.
Hang on. What about an angel?
Oh, Angel. No, I don't do angels. No.
That's all right.
No, I don't do angels.
We've got Jasmine Lowson with the Big Breakfast News and Weather.
Yay!
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of December. Roll over Rocco for the Highland Hitch, the Christmas Getaway, if you can, and a nice one for the Beatles. They're doing it lock, stock and barrel today. Madonna and Guy get hitched in the Highlands, but not before baby Rocco managed to cause a commotion. Here's Simone Sutcliffe.
Yesterday's christening of baby Rocco was the perfect support act. Guy Ritchie and Madonna were joined by their showbiz pals Sting, Gwyneth Paltrow, Stella McCartney and Rupert Everett. And while our very own Richard Bacon tried to breach security, a 51-year-old man was arrested after being found inside Dornoch Cathedral during the service. Today's wedding at Skibo Castle is private. If it goes to plan, the world will get to see just one official photograph.
New Labour's hold on Scotland took another battering last night. Blair's man Eric Joyce won the Falkirk West by-election. But Labour's majority was slashed from 14,000 to just 705 by the SNP. The Great Christmas Getaway gets underway this afternoon. On the railways, the GNER East Coast mainline is only running at 40% of its services. Traffic chaos is expected at major hotspots, including the M25 at the M3 and M4 junctions. Airlines are urging those flying to leave plenty of time to check in. Neil Hamilton's considering taking his case to Europe after another lost court battle against Mohamed Al-Fayed. The former Tory MP called the court decision justice in Wonderland. Lucky the Beatles released their compilation album One in time for Christmas. The perfect baby boomer gift has been flying off shelves around the world at a rate of 6 copies a minute. Here's the sport. Coventry City tonight hope to complete a hat-trick of victories over Southampton in just 5 months. The Sky Blues recorded their first away win for more than a year at the Dell in August. 2 months later, they knocked the Saints out of the Worthington Cup. Venus Williams supposedly needed the money. The Wimbledon winner has clinched a record sports sponsorship deal for women, a five-year tie-up with a sportswear firm worth £26 million. Not bad. That's the Big Breakfast News. Simon's at the house with the weather.
Thanks very much, Jasmine Lowson. Now, here's the weather. Dry and cold with a few bright spells today, particularly in the west. This morning, eastern Britain will have a grey, murky start, I'm afraid. You might see a bit of fog on some of the hills there as well, and indeed, little smidges of drizzle in parts. In western and southern districts, though, you might see a couple more brighter spells after a bit of a musky start or even a misty start. A chilly easterly wind, though, is going to be making it feel quite nippy today. This afternoon, still mostly dry, but still rather cold, I'm afraid. Cloudy in the east, a little bit brighter in the west. Southwest England might see a little bit of rain. It's that symbol there if you're quite unlucky, but you may be able to avoid it. Very low percentages chance of rain today, so that's good news. And Scotland might see a bit of rain tempered even by sleet, which is quite exciting. A quick look at today's temperatures then. 6 for Aberdeen, 7 in Belfast, a 5 for the Midlands, 7 for us here in London, and an 8 for the southwest. A quick look ahead to the Christmas weekend. In the north, much colder, I'm afraid. Chances of snow in some parts of Scotland. For the middle, dry and cloudy on Saturday, colder with showers on Sunday, and for the south, dull with a smattering of rain, I'm afraid. Now we're going to go to an interview with Phil Cornwell, but first, here's a clip of the man in action.
Here, you see that? That's Van Morrison and Sting. Do you know?
Yes.
I don't know what they're doing here in Seaforth. Mind you, I don't know what I'm doing here in Seaforth, neither.
Oh, yeah, the money doesn't look good,
believe it or not, that was not the real Michael Caine, neither was it the real Sting in that clip.
No.
In fact, it was our next guest, the man who quite literally breathes life into those characters.
Thank you, Johnny.
He is a man, he's a legend, he's a reclusive millionaire.
He is.
He is Phil Cornwell! OK, who came up with the idea of Stella Street? Just for those who haven't seen it, tell them what Stella Street is as well while you answer that question.
I will. Stella Street is a place where all these famous people live, and it's like am I getting boring?
No.
The idea was Peter Richardson, our director, he thought it'd be great to have me and John get together, see what we came up with, and that's what we came up with.
Right.
But the first idea we had was, what about Mick and Keith running a corner shop? That'll be a funny idea. Right. So that's how it started. Then we thought, why don't we have a whole street with people living in it, you know?
OK, so Peter Richardson of Comic Strip.
Yes. Peter Richardson of Comic Strip fame, yes, okay. Definitely. And he's our, we all write it together and everything, the three of us.
It's written, you don't just improv it.
No, we have to.
A lot of the things, I know you have to do all the setups, it must be very complex, costume changes.
All that, yes, yeah.
It actually always looks quite off.
We have to structure it really and write it, otherwise it would take forever to do, you know what I mean? But we do actually script it, yeah.
So what sort of reaction do you get from celebrities that you impersonate?
Pretty favourable, actually. Michael's a big fan of the show, I think, Michael Caine. And Mick and Keith, apparently, whether it's apocryphal or not, watch it on the tour bus. Because Keith apparently said, I want to buy that shop, man. Apparently he said that. And of course, as we know, David Bowie, I was sitting next to him
in the makeup chair, and he looks up, we're talking about it, and he goes, does my skin look buttery?
Johnny was there.
Anyway, recently some new residents have moved into the street, haven't they?
Yeah. He's a natural, isn't he?
No, I'll just read questions. I can naturally do that.
We've got new residents, Jimmy Savile, right?
Do you do the sound?
It's very like that, you see. You see, it's very, very dark. I go to some very dark places, Johnny. The hole in the soul, feel that bottomless pit, that emptiness, you see. No, there's
Jimmy
all that.
Savile,
Patrick Moore, John gives us a
lodger. He's a lodger with who?
Absolutely marvellous, Patrick Moore. Lodging with Alan Rickman and Jimmy and Jimmy Savile in Jimmy Hill's house.
In Jimmy Hill's house.
And Jimmy Hill. Bears no resemblance to the real Jimmy Hill. It's just my character. He goes completely insane. He gets madder and madder and madder in this series that's on at the moment.
So if you lived in Stella Street, who would you hate to have as your neighbour?
Oh, Jimmy Hill, without a doubt, you know. Twitching curtains, you know, all that. yeah, off his head completely.
Roger Moore, I presume, is there for the new series as well.
Yeah. I've had a suntan all my life.
Roger's there. I love Roger. I love Roger. He's great. Roger and Michael, yeah.
How do you decide kind of who does who? Do you sort of compete for who can do it better?
Not really. It's quite diplomatically done, you know. A lot of them we can do. We can, like Mick and Keith. John can do Mick and Keith. I can do Mick and Keith. But we've settled on it quite diplomatically, really. John's Keith is brilliant, you know.
But you're Mick. Sorry, go on.
Sorry, does it come naturally, or do you have to really work at it?
No, we're very lazy, Dan. I mean, we're not in the business of satire or trying to do great new people or anything like that. We just do who we can do. And even Tommy Cooper's in this bloody series. You know, I shouldn't be swearing.
No, actually, you shouldn't, and I didn't even notice it. That's what's really normally I prick up. Whoa, swear word.
Court, love. See you
no,
in court.
I pricked up. I noticed it.
Did you? Sorry that he just said the B word.
But we just do who we can do, and we enjoy it. You know what I mean?
You're Mick Jagger, which I think is the Mick Jagger that people actually imitate. People don't imitate Mick Jagger, they imitate you doing Mick Jagger.
No, they sort of take that, you know.
And the voice when it sort of goes like that.
Then it kind of goes down like that.
But I first heard that and first started imitating Mick, way back in the Steve Wright days.
Yes, that's right, yeah.
Was that a good part of your career when you were part of Steve Wright's gang?
It was excellent, actually, you know, because I just used to make it up as I went along, basically, and it was quite liberating, really, you know. We'd just go in there and just record a load, you know, and... Yeah, Mick and Keith. It was insane. It was quite insane, Johnny.
Yeah, it was insane. And you used to also do Gilbert on a show, didn't you, in the morning? Do you remember Gilbert, that little dragon?
Yeah.
Do you remember
Gilbert the alien?
That was Phil.
Gilbert
the alien. He used to say really offensive things.
Do you remember that? Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Yeah. I remember one morning he had Aswad on. And you kept going, good skiing up. And I thought, this is a children's show. And
I did.
Wow, he's coming out. I was like, yeah, I was going to say.
And I insulted a few people on that, actually. I did. And I did tell Donny Osmond to get back to the Partridge Family.
Nice.
Where he belonged. Yes. Nice. And he went, bosh, and he gave me a right hander.
But someone was out of control. It spat a lot, didn't it, that monster?
It was out of control. I was out of control. Gilbert was out of control. It was just, you know, it was my early funny days, Johnny, because I know you like a lot of my early funny stuff, don't you?
I love your early stuff. That's always how you can slightly put a comedian down while bringing him up. It's called negative stroking. Love your early stuff. Fantastic. OK, Phil.
OK, so just very quickly before we play this game that we've got for you. This is the third series. Are you planning to do another one?
Yeah, we've got... there's a special out on January the 3rd. It's like a whole 40 minutes.
Oh, it's like a dream.
40 minutes special. Great plug.
I hope that doesn't affect your video sales.
We haven't sold any videos, because there's so many of them in HMV. Yeah. I happen to see them there. There's a lot of them.
Depressing.
In the bargain bucket, not yet.
Right, okay.
It's January the 3rd at 11:20 on BBC Two. Got to get that in.
I feel
so
the need
people
for
will watch it then.
I feel the need for a game, Phil.
I do.
Oh, do you, mate?
As it's Christmas, I'm sure you won't begrudge us a few more impressions. A bit of festive fun. We put presents addressed to celebrities in this Christmas stocking. Denise now has that Christmas stocking.
Okay.
Each gift contains a clue to a common Yuletide situation. We'd like to perform that task as the celebrity getting the present. So,
okay, this is Happy Christmas, and this is from...
This is to De Niro. Happy Christmas, Robert De Niro. Would you like to open the present and see what it is?
Nice.
I gather it will become... I should get my clipboard, because it's got all the instructions. Clipboard,
feel. Oh! What is it?
It's a scroll.
OK, this is a scroll. This is a present to Robert De Niro.
To Robert De Niro.
This is an extract from the Queen's speech in the style of Robert De Niro.
Extract.
I
just want to say my husband and I have had a good year, and we're going to keep Fergie down in the garden in a cottage. We're going to keep her there, because she's no good. We don't like her, she's no good. What did I say? What did I tell you? What?
That's the Queen's speech, isn't it?
It's not bad, is it? OK, this is festive fun to Jimmy Hill.
Oh,
Jimmy.
Yes, I wonder what it is. look, it's a Santa.
Santa, I'll tell you what we have to do with Santa is writing a Christmas list to Santa as Jimmy Hill.
Oh, Christmas list to Santa. Football My Way by Johnny Haynes, please, Santa. Some interesting plants for the garden. a crate of absinthe. loads of... puddings of various types.
And, that's enough, okay.
This is a good one, because we haven't seen you do this one this morning.
I don't know if you can do it. I don't know if you can do it. Can you do
Des
Lynam?
Hey, tell you what. All right, need a moustache. Give it a go. All right, bit of a smoothie, bit of a twinkle, bit of a ladies man. All right.
Slightly disjointed.
Slightly, but hey, what do we got here? Tell you what, unflappable. Okay.
Okay, this is a box of stuffing, I gather.
Box of stuffing,
this is stuffing the Christmas turkey.
as Des Lynham.
Do you want me to be the turkey?
Actually, don't think I'll do that. Could be a little bit offensive to people. tell you what, got an imaginary turkey here. Going to open it up, get the giblets out. All right, shove the stuffing in there like my grandmother used to do. Little glass of sherry by the side. Nice Christmas, Yuletide, festive spirit. All right, not too depressed, bit of a dark hole in there. Doesn't matter.
You love the darkness, don't you?
I do.
That's Johnny, one of you, two measures of the darkness.
We've got time for one more. Yeah, because this is a good one.
You love it. Savile and Lynham, dark figures. That's brilliant.
This is my favourite, so we have to do this one.
Phil Gordon, you're a shocker. This is Mick Jagger. I don't know what's in there. You have to open it up.
Oh, nice one. Happy Christmas, Mick.
I don't know what it's going to be.
I've got everything. It can't be anything that I haven't got.
I think it could be a hymn book.
Oh, no, great. I am slightly pious.
OK, you've got to sing a Christmas carol in the style of Mick Jagger.
Right. No, well, all right, OK.
It's not the right words, am I?
No, well, it is. Good King Wenceslas last looked out on the Feast of Stephen when the snow lay round about deep in Christmas Eve.
Well, all right. Do the clap.
Do that again. Oh, please, just do it with the clap. It's just the clap.
Well, all right, I'm going to tell you now. Away in a manger. Well, all right. Well, that must be horrible.
Ladies and gentlemen,
people.
Mr. Phil Cole. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Clap. Will you stick with us all morning?
I might have to go, actually. Oh.
Really?
I'm busy, love, I'm busy.
Have you got more TVs today?
Spreading myself thinly, mate.
OK, nice one.
Bit of a VO, love.
Bit of a VO. Are you doing a VO this morning?
Bit of a VO, love. Squeezing one in.
OK, you actually did one for me recently. I was chuffed with that. Do you know what? We're going to take a break now. Back in a couple of seconds. Hope you're enjoying the Big Breakfast this morning. It's our last live one of this year.
My diary, day 8. I don't like the elf, and I think that the snowman's starting to melt.
Ready for Christmas time with Thornton's huge selection of chocolate treats. Thornton's, there's lots in store for you.
My romance doesn't have to have a moon in the sky. You.
Ralph Lauren Romance. For men, for women.
You see this number, 0500 000 121. It's called a free phone number, and that's because it's free to phone it. And when you do, that's exactly what you get, a free phone, with free connection to 121. Brilliant! And not just any old free phone. Call digital cell phones now on 0500 000 121 and you could order this Siemens C35i. It's small, it's sexy. Remind you of anyone? Or you could choose the musical Motorola V2288 WAP phone with built-in FM radio. Or how about this cute little Ericsson T10 flip phone with vibrating alert?
Or the cool Nokia 3310.
Whichever phone you choose, it will be dispatched to you free the same day. For your free phone, call digital cell phones now on 0500 000 121. OK, hands up, who wants the Siemens?
You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why.
Santa Claus coming to town. Santa Claus coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
But more importantly, give it up for Craig from Big Brother. Yay! Oh, don't disturb him. He's trying to get everybody to buy his single.
Imagine her face when she unwraps it on Christmas Day. Right. She's going to look. What do you mean, Bob Bill's got bigger muscles than me? He hasn't. And you want Westlife to go to number one?
As you can see, Craig is giving the hard sell there. Craig, are you managing to get a lot of your singles sold?
It's very hard. Yeah, we've got loads sold.
Yes? Yep. What kind of things are you saying to encourage people to get that single?
Well, I'm trying to tell them not to go for Westlife. And Bob the Builder hasn't got bigger muscles than me.
Yes.
But if you do buy it at Christmas time, wrap it up for the girlfriend.
Yes.
Imagine her face when you unwrap it.
Okay, and of course it is for a good cause, yeah, which is what we're, what it's all about, isn't it?
So get off the phone and get down to the shop.
So you keep giving it the hard sell there, Craig. If you'd like to talk to Craig, you can call us on 0208985, all the ones.
Yeah,
or you can fax me on 0208985, all the twos, but ideally we do want your telephone calls to talk to Craig. Anyway, at this time of year we do like a bit of a giveaway, Denise.
Is that what you like, Donna? Do you like to give it away at this time of year?
We like to give it away. All right, so go on then, get on with it. You're doing the raffle.
It's not me, it's Johnny.
Oh, all right, it's Johnny, it's not Denise.
She likes to give it away.
You've all got a raffle ticket, haven't you? OK, all this week we've been giving you the chance to win the three most desirable gifts this Christmas. How about that, Gary? The big three. If you know anything about what the kids want, you will know what I'm talking about. Right, gang? OK, we finally whittled the baying mob down to 50, ladies and gentlemen. And what better way as it's Christmas? Please. A lot of you are going to go away home today very disappointed indeed. I'm going to tell you that now, yes? But we've always got this moment. Please, wave your raffle tickets now for all you want. And you know why? Because you made it down to the big breakfast. Many are called, 50 have been chosen. Did I hit your head then as I walked past? Okay. In keeping with grand traditions of the Great British Raffle, I'm ably assisted by a minor celebrity, ladies and gentlemen, Craig from Big Brother.
Is he here? Is he hiding? No, who are you, Johnny? Who are
you? No, I'll vote you out of this house, mate. Okay, we've also got the Deputy Mayor and Mayoress of Hackney. Right, will you please now, Craig, turn the tombola on! Thank you very much. OK, tombola is open. Please, when you look at the prize number, don't say which number
don't
is on which prize,
on
yeah? I'll tell you what also is in the raffle, just to take you through this, you've got a signed photo of Simon Fielder. Oh. You've got bubble bath, every granny's favourite. A weekend for two at the Elms Hotel in Bear Morecambe. I've got down here famed for its shrimps. A turkey and all the trimmings. Our star prize, this year's most sought-after toys. You win them all. It's not just like you, the three of you might be lucky and get one each. Just one person gets the lot. That's it. And every raffle favourite, the cuddly toy! OK, let's go. What's the first number, please?
The first number is 230.
230, who's got it? Eon. OK, now we're going to find out what is 230. Let's have a look. Stand back, please. OK, the mayor and mayoress, let's have a quick look to see what number 230 is. There's a prize here somewhere. Oh, it's getting tense. I think it's
a photo.
Is it all of them? First off, let's have a look. Let's have a look. Hang on. It is you! You won the lot! First number out there. Oh, thanks, Craig. Thank you so very much. Well, that leaves me with a nice big hole in the show. Ladies and gentlemen, he gets it all. You get, well, whatever's left. Ladies and gentlemen, the raffle guy, if I was you, I'd take that lot as soon as possible and just go. Run. There is a mood of bitterness in the air. I can't believe he pulled it out first time. God. Boo him, boo. 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 enough, gang. Cruel but fair. Yeah. Thanks very much. OK, let's spin it. I like the way you're still quite excited, aren't you? Even though there's absolute rubbish,
I
think.
Because they can still win a signed photo of Simon
Fielder. Simon Fielder! 20 years in the Mets. A booby prize, if you win nothing, Barry has said anyone who loses and still feels like a loser, he'll roll him in a blanket and give him a right good kicking. Okay. Yeah.
The next one
is... 280 again.
It's not.
Nobody kidding.
It's 378.
378, which one's 378?
Look at your tickets.
It's a Teddy.
Who's got it? Who's got 378? Have you got 378? Let's see it. Come up to the counter.
I don't want anything else.
You've won the Teddy. Yay! I tell you what. If you'd like to just join Denise and Donna over there. Maybe they'll give you a little.
As
a booby, as it could be quite literally a booby prize. Nice touch. Could you sort of rub yourselves around a bit?
My children again, please.
There we go. That's kind of worth it. There we go. Right. Okay. Spin it, please.
Spin.
Tombola magic. Okay. 406. I know what 406 is. I think. We got a winner. Who's the winner? Come forward, madam. Never have a dull bath time again. Swim in the ocean waves. Do you know what that sign there means? It means 89p that cost us. That's what that cost us. How much did it cost you to get down here today?
Quite a lot.
Oh, there we go. There we go. 89p. Please, join the winning. Join the winning crush.
Bit of a downer.
Okay, here we go. Okay, here we go. Spin it, please, wee man. Spin, tombola man.
Which one is? Number five.
Now, I know. Who's number five? Come forward, please. No, you haven't. You've won country vegetable soup. No, it's not opened, gone. Please join them in the winner's pen. And now, spin, tombola man. Truly, he is the greatest tombola man in the world.
And here's 158.
Oh, I don't. No. What is it? You've won the turkey! God, but all the time, you might have that turkey. Think of what you could have won.
I know.
Yeah, no, but you could look at that.
Look at it. Barbecue.
Seriously, get together with soup, man. You can have quite a lunch. Please, it's hot. It's ready to eat. Take your turkey, madam. And now there is only, I think, one ticket left in. Unfortunately, the opposite of what we wanted to happen has happened. We wanted to build this up to the three most coveted presents this Christmas and start with Simon Fielder. Instead, Fielder is the finale. And what has turned out to be a miserable disaster. OK, please, spin, tombola man. There is only one in there, I think, Craigie.
There's only one.
Okay.
This is it.
Oh, there's more.
436.
436, I think. 436 gets you. Who is it? Who is the unhappiest man in Britain this morning? There we go. There's your signed picture.
It's a dream.
It's like a dream, isn't it? Pinch yourself. Okay, there we go. Which means. Is there one more in there?
No more in there.
There should be one more in there for the hotel at Morecambe.
Oh,
he's just shoved it back in. Tombola man. Who has got number 378?
That, haven't we?
Okay, classic. Okay.
What number's that?
What's this one?
What have we got? 105. What number is that?
Don't you think my plan was rather evil? What is the number for the hotel in Morecambe? We'll find out right after the break. What is the number for the holiday? Yeah, last year I was on that Gloria Hunniford's mantelpiece, you know? Whew, the stories I could tell. Whish. Filth.
Let's see then. Where'd you get the money for all this?
I only paid for two. You get the cheapest one free.
Come on, get your coat back on.
But it's true.
Let's see what the store manager has to say.
You won't believe what Boots are offering this Christmas. Now choose from a different range of gifts. Look for the parcel symbol.
Pocket the world is not enough. At Asda.
Who are you?
My name's Bond.
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 James Bond.
And right now, if you buy The World Is Not Enough on video, you'll get another Bond video absolutely free.
Bond. Bond.
Bond. Bond.
That's Asda price.
Detox wipes safely kill harmful bacteria such as Salmonella and E. coli, and are bleach-free and leave no taint or odour. Life demands Detox.
You see this number, 0500 treble 0121. It's called a free phone number, and that's because it's free to phone it. And when you do, that's exactly what you get, a free phone, with free connection to 1-to-1. Brilliant! And not just any old free phone. Call digital cell phones now on 0500 treble 0121 and you could order this Siemens C35i. It's small, it's sexy. Remind you of anyone? Or you could choose the musical Motorola V2288 WAP phone with built-in FM radio. Or how about this cute little Ericsson T10 flip phone with vibrating alert?
Or the cool Nokia 3310.
Whichever phone you choose, it will be dispatched to you free the same day. For your free phone, call digital cell phones now on 0500 treble 0121. OK, hands up, who wants the Siemens?
Welcome back to the Big Breakfast. Terrible letdown.
I'm loving this raffle.
Can we just know who the organiser was? Who forgot to put that one ticket in that's caused all the problem? And I think it was... It's the guy in the dunce's hat, wherever he is. Where's he gone? It's you! Again, twice! Twice! You put rechargeable, unrechargeable, rechargeable batteries in a rabbit, and now you've done this. What do you see as your key strengths?
Organisation.
Organisation, I love that. OK. We have come up with a system, though. Denise, we've got everyone to write their numbers on their hands.
Good idea.
Rosie, have you refereed that?
Yeah.
OK, have you got all the numbers in?
So you need to collect the tickets.
OK, let's collect all the tickets up, please.
Can I take them over?
This is for a holiday in Morecambe, where I gather they have great shrimps.
I'll take them over, yeah.
Oh, and illuminations. While that's all going on, Denise, we tell them what's coming up on today's show.
Here's what's still to come on this morning's show. After the news, Richard Bacon splits in two and rolls into Christmas for the final time.
Hey. At 9:40, we change into Top Gear and get those tyres smoking. With the new movie, Where's the Car, Dude? In the Sizzler.
And then at 9:45, it's Door Knock and One Stalking Presenter with Richard Bacon's prenuptial report on Madge and Guy's wedding, which is happening today.
Plus, ladies and gentlemen, it could be the loudest rendition ever of The Friday Song! OK, then, are we in a position to go ahead with this?
Yes.
Should we do this before? Are we ready to rock?
Yeah.
OK,
yeah.
This big to the wait, Tombola Man!
Johnny, let's do it after the
let's
news!
Let's do it after the news.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of December. Madge and Guy go up the aisle. Will it be white or wet this Christmas? And Santa's warming up for the festive season. Madonna and Guy get hitched in the Highlands today after yesterday's christening of baby Rocco. As a support act to today's wedding at Skibo Castle, his was an impressive guest list. Sting and wife Trudy, Gwyneth Paltrow and Stella McCartney were all there to help wet his head.
The Great Christmas Getaway gets underway this afternoon. On the railways, the GNER East Coast Mainline is only running at 40% of its services. Traffic chaos is expected at major hotspots, including the M25 at the M3 and M4 junctions. Airlines are urging those flying to leave plenty of time to check in. With Christmas falling on a Monday, retailers are expecting a huge rush of people hitting the shops this weekend. Until now, the high streets have been relatively quiet. Many stores will be staying open until 9 o'clock at night to catch last-minute buyers. It looks like a dramatic year for weather could be topped off with a white Christmas. That's according to the bookies, who slashed the odds for snow on the 25th to between 6-1 in Bristol to 11-8 on in Manchester. It looks like there'll be no shrimps on the barbie this Christmas down under. A total fire ban has put a dampener on the traditional seafood barbecue after an outbreak of bushfires. The Aussie turkey population is now on red alert. Bob's still building up to winning the number one spot in the Christmas chart. Sales of Can We Fix It are raising the roof, with numbers extending way over Westlife's boy band Ballad. Let's hope he's hit the nail on the head again this Sunday and finally fixed it. It seems Santa's set to get a bit hot under the collar. Santa's hometown on the Arctic Circle in Finland has recorded its warmest winter for 40 years. It's got the big guy concerned about global warming.
If I remember, it's about 40 years since we've had this mild start for the winter.
That's the Big Breakfast News. Simon's at the house with the weather.
Oh, thanks very much, Jasmine Lowson. Now, what can we expect today? It's very nearly Christmas, so it's kind of wintry, dry and cold, mainly. Eastern Britain start off a little bit murky this morning, bit of fog, maybe even a bit of drizzle here and there. But in the west and in the south, you might catch a couple of brighter spells after a misty start. There is a chilly easterly wind, though, that's piercing through the country, making it feel rather nippy today. This afternoon, still mostly dry, but still rather chilly. Cloudy in the east, I'd imagine. Grey, a bit brighter along this western coast. In the southwest, unfortunately, might catch a bit of rain. If you're in the north of Scotland, you might even get a bit of sleet up there. That's all from me. If I don't see you before the end of the show, well, have a nice Christmas. And back to Johnny now.
Okay. Wait a second. Here's the deal, viewers. We had a tombola. The tombola's to win those top three ungettable, unbuyable Christmas presents. Sadly, they went first, leaving us a great big hole in the show. All right, stop it now, tombola man. Deputy Mayor and Mayoress of Hackney, how much of a debacle was that? Have you ever presided over something so shambolic?
Can you say that again? I've enjoyed every moment of it.
You've enjoyed every moment?
Yes.
What about the Mayoress?
Yes, I did.
You thought it was quite entertaining?
Oh, it's very, very...
But when you do tombolas, are they a bit slicker than this? Yeah, you can be honest, you can be honest. Another trick, don't... You know, do you think it was shambolic? Be careful, because he's near the edge.
No.
OK, thank you very much indeed. That's thank the lawyer you. Talking.
Thank okay. you.
Is the lawyers on the phone? Oh, that's good. Anyway, what we've done is everyone has written down their raffle ticket numbers now on their hands. Yay! This is for a holiday in Morecambe.
Lovely shrimps!
Where they have lovely shrimps, and you can also illuminations. Thank you very much, Denise Van Outen. So, because we didn't have the raffle ticket in there, that's why I'm having to do this. I've had to devise this system. I want you to write them all on your heads. But we've devised this system. We're away. Tombola man, now please do your best.
Spin, tombola man. Spin, tombola man. Spin, tombola man.
Reach tombola boy.
And the winner is 431.
Who's 431? Yes, indeed. Well done. Well done. You're going to Morecambe. You get to go to Morecambe for the whole night. Where do you live?
Croydon!
Croydon! God, but that is a Morecambe. And what a final downer that would have been. Give it up, please, for everybody here, ladies and gentlemen.
Bacon roll.
Bacon roll. You're going to Morecambe. You're going to Morecambe. We're not. Bacon rolls.
Having fun, it's the season. Love and understanding.
won't come unless you're asleep.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
No, viewers, I'm not in the United States. I'm still in England, continuing my search for the spirit of Christmas. A search which brings me here, to Boston in Lincolnshire.
This quaint town dates back to Roman times. It takes its name from the Latin Bostonium, meaning pleasant area.
Is this... will this make your Christmas?
Oh, this is smashing. Yes, it certainly will.
Okay.
It certainly will. I remember this all my life.
Well, in goes Mrs. Humphries into the car. You can't leave litter like that. I can't let you leave litter like that. Have you got, excuse me, anyone got a tissue or something? We need to clear up these chips. If you walk away and leave those chips on the floor, yeah. I will be forced to make a citizen's arrest.
That's real leather.
That's real leather, and this is real walnut. You can touch that.
Yeah, that's beautiful, isn't it? Yeah.
Well, shut the door. We'll let you sit. We'll let have your moment to yourself, Mrs. Humphries.
Yes.
Go on.
It is disgusting.
What is?
Leaving that like that.
Isn't it?
It is.
It is.
It is disgusting.
It is. Well, come and tell her, will you? Come here. Just come here. She's over
you
it.
You should pick the tray up at least.
No, she should though, shouldn't she?
Who are you recording for?
No, big breakfast. Tell her, just tell her again.
You should pick the tray up. The birds will eat the chips, but they won't eat the tray.
So there, Mrs. Humphries, enjoying her moment. Just talking to herself, feeling regal. Happy Christmas, Mrs. Humphries. Hello there. Hello, we're from the Big Breakfast. Is anyone? We've come to turn on your Christmas tree lights. Well, I've come to turn on your Christmas tree lights. It's a bit of a Christmas surprise and a treat. Well, I've now been given a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to appear in Cinderella at the Blackfriars Arts Centre here in Boston. They didn't have a minor celebrity on the cast list until now. Being a minor celebrity, turning on Christmas lights is a duty, but it's a duty that I readily accept. Here we go, then. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
go!
Oh, you're so right, Your Highness. It is not chance that draws us together. It's fate that brings us like this.
I seem to have come over all the.
I don't recognise you.
Obvious. I was hoping that maybe I made more of an impression than this.
You look a different person now.
But I've still got the makeup on.
Excuse me, ladies.
How the way of you, Your
Honour? I'd like one of your fine pies to fill my belly before a hard day's sport.
I've just been on stage. You've just seen me. You can't remember a single thing I did.
Yes.
Well, what did I do?
You've just... Sister!
Someone whispered that from off camera.
Now, if I don't make a mark, then I don't.
Well, that concludes my search for the true spirit of Christmas. Something I think I've found. I hope that wherever you are, you're with the ones you love at this time of year. All that remains for me to say is have yourself a very Merry Christmas. Goodbye.
Hot mince pie?
Don't be stupid, Denise. I'm a snowman.
Miles has learned that nobody comes whether he cries or not. A door. A table. A fist. His abuser says he'll come and get Tom if he does. Sometimes we need to open our eyes to the suffering that's all around us and work together to stop it. Please pledge just £2 a month to the NSPCC by calling 0800 32 32 31 now. Your £2 a month will help run our Child Protection Helpline, which anyone can call if they fear for a child's safety. Run centres where families can go for support, advice, or simply somewhere for the children to play. Be there for children in desperate need. Please, open your eyes and your heart. Call the NSPCC now on 0800 32 32 31 and give £2 a month or whatever you can. Together, we can help stop cruelty to children, full stop. Let us start now.
Two fragrances.
Get together.
Emporio Armani.
Please pledge just £2 a month to the NSPCC by calling 0800 32 32 31 now.
Morning. And guess what, everybody? It's Friday!
Yeah!
It's the start of your Christmas weekend.
Oh, what a touch! What a touch!
Now, you may think that the biggest story this week is Madge's wedding, but she's not the only celebrity making news in Door Knock.
Well, there's right. Richard Bacon here, as you now see him. Quite okay. Civilised, isn't he?
But look, yesterday on
ITN News. Let's have a look. I think we should be able to play this in.
Madonna will marry Guy Ritchie in Door Knock. From there, Linda Kennedy reports.
At Door Knock Cathedral, scene of the christening, it's crazy. To bemusement of police, one TV crew tried to go inside, but failed. In the long wait for tonight's big event, this was worthy of attention from media rivals.
I fancy interviewing you on Murray Firth Radio.
Yeah, we're a bit of luck.
No one here knows if they're coming or going.
Oh, Richie Bacon, they love you. They love crime, they love petty crime. They love to see a man being arrested.
Thank you. I mean, I think in many ways, you know, it's a badge of honour. ITN are up here doing a report about Madonna, and I take up half the report. I'm very proud.
I think it was the only exciting footage they had, Rich. Listen, I'm going to let you run with the ball now, Rich. Did you have a good night last night, overall?
Yeah. Yes, yeah, I had a great night last night. We had a lovely Indian and a lot to drink, and I threw up. All in all, it was good.
And that is how you should celebrate your first arrest. How British is he? He gets arrested for troublemaking. Part of Tony Blair's You're Britain.
Careful, careful, Johnny. We've got Barry 20 years in the Met.
Sorry, 20 years in the Met.
20 years.
20, a man and boy.
I was very envious of the policeman there, grabbing his collar.
You see collars being felt, it's not your hand, green with envy.
Brought it all back, Johnny, brought it all back.
I can't tell you what, Richie, a big, big day today. Go on, let him roll with the ball.
Yeah, he run with the ball, Rich, go on.
Richie! Yeah, thank you very much indeed. Yeah, welcome back to Door Knock. There's the cathedral where the christening was yesterday. It's the wedding later on today. First of all, I just want to apologise. I want to say sorry. I've written it, actually. Pass it here, Paul, pass me the thing. I just want to say this. I would like to apologise unreservedly to the staff and guests of the wonderful Mansfield Hotel. My behaviour there was not fitting of the grace and dignity expected of somebody in my position. Thank you. Sorry?
Yeah.
Thank you. Right, I'm going to press on. Now, it's my last day here. I came here 3 weeks ago to do a preview. I'm about to leave Door Knock, and I'm sure the people are very sad. Door Knockians! You sad that I'm leaving?
No, stay longer.
But therefore, you are sad that I'm leaving. Are you a Madonna fan yourself?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Did you see her when she was down here
no,
yesterday?
No.
You must be bitterly disappointed.
I know, I am, yeah.
Okay, and you there, you've got a baby as well. Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, lovely. Right, thank you very much, Dornockians. Now, this gentleman over here is Alex. He's a journalist from Switzerland. One of the country's leading journalists, I understand.
Thank you.
I noticed you've got an unusual microphone. We go for a cube, you've got this triangular thing, yeah. But it's quite nice.
Triangle.
It's lovely. Now listen, I slept through the christening yesterday. I've not got many stories. Did you have a jacuzzi in your hotel?
No.
I did. This is where I was. We're going to Skibo Castle. Sorry, I'm getting the VT order wrong. I'll show you my jacuzzi in a second. I just want to show the viewers something. The wedding is at Skibo Castle. More naive crews are outside Skibo Castle, but they can see nothing. We passed by this morning and filmed it, and this is all they can see. This is it. Have a look. There. Isn't that rubbish, isn't it? Huh? Do you know GMTV? They'll be there. Rubbish. We're here. Now, Alex, I slept through the christening yesterday. I said, have a look at my jacuzzi. Can we just play the jacuzzi? Is it spooled and ready to run? I'd like to show Alex, my friend here, my special bubbling bath, which is where I was yesterday. Just queuing it up. Now, hang on. Any side? There. Oh. There, look at that. Wow, that's where I spent the christening. So I've not got many stories. I need an exclusive from you, Macy, about the wedding, some information, please.
Okay, I have no information. We arrived this morning.
A journalist.
Yes, sure.
He's got nothing.
We arrived this morning and we have a story tonight, okay. So it's okay.
I sometimes wonder, because you obviously are a sort of very straight journalist, do you sometimes sort of feel trapped in your job? Do you know what I mean? You sometimes want to break free and be
a bit
wacky?
Okay. Yep, I am a proper journalist, so...
Okay, and you're very proud of that.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. You can go. I'm done. Thank you very much. Now, these two, I've got to press on. I've not got long left, but also you two here, it's Paul and Pauline. That's you've right. Supplied me with this kilt today. I understand that this is the exact kilt that Guy Ritchie will be wearing later.
We hope so. It'll be very similar. This is a Macintosh tartan kilt, so okay. He will be wearing that. Which one, we're not sure.
Ritchie is of the clan Macintosh, Pauline.
Well, that's right. He's a sept of Macintosh. Ritchie. Okay. Comes under that clan.
Thank you very much. And also, you two guys here, listen, I'm out of time, so I've got to press on. But can I say it's Talitha, isn't it? And Mark, just tell me this. Yeah. You actually work at Skibo Castle, where the wedding is taking place.
Yes.
I know that you've signed a contract of secrecy and you can't tell us things, but can you give us some idea of the splendour that that Madonna and Guy will be enjoying today?
Well, it's just like taking a step back in time. It's just everything's the original and everyone gets treated very well and it's just beautiful, so...
Thank you very much. No time to hear from you. Don't even speak. Okay. Right, thank you. I've got to go to a break. As I go to the break, why don't we have some lovely music? Let me get your names again. I've got it in my pocket. Go on. Stars. It's Clan and drummer with some local flavour for us. And there they go. Bye bye, Dornock! Bye bye! It's been wonderful! I will miss you all! Right, that's it from us in Scotland. Meanwhile, this is Channel 4, you're watching The Big Breakfast, and here's a break.
Memo, all departments must speak to agent.
You're once, twice. This is Motown Mania, the album. Three times, lady. Classic Motown hits performed by today's chart-topping stars, including brand new tracks from Steps, A1, Samantha Mumba, Westlife, and S Club 7. It's Motown Mania, and it's out now.
Chanel number 5. I
turn to you. Let Melanie C's Northern Star light up your life. Featuring the number one smash hit, I Turn to You, and Never Be the Same Again. Did we
plus the brand new single, If That Were Me. Can we get a Melanie C, Northern Star, shining brightly.
Matt, married man lingering on the blonde there, Matt. I'm not being funny, but married man, there's a big crowd of 50 here, just lingering on.
You've got it wrong, Johnny. You think he's excited because of the blonde. It's not, it's because we've got some hot food about to enter the
exactly
house.
Right. That is a miracle.
A turkey dinner.
Turkey dinner. Come on in, Roger.
Roger.
He's been
barbecuing the turkey every year. Here he comes. Might need help with... No, he can do that. He can do this. He's a barbecue man. He can do that.
Go on, off you go.
The old Bandora. Thanks, Rog. I think it's time to hear Roger's catchphrase. Ladies and gentlemen, how did he cook this? Because the convected heat goes round and round. Roger, thank you very much for coming down. Roger, ladies and gentlemen, we've also got to thank the other guests today who have been Denise.
We have had Phil Cornwell, Craig from Big Brother. Good luck with the Christmas season. Good luck with Christmas. Bobby Builder, a barbecue expert, Roger Barrett, Richard Bacon on the outside broadcast, Donna Eyre. This morning, the Deputy Mayor and Mayoress of Hackney.
Yes, well.
And of course,
I tell you what, they presided over a shambles this morning, didn't they? And I lay the blame squarely at their feet.
Also, I'd like to say thank you to Santa for coming all the way from Colchester Zoo. And Tombola Man.
Closing headlines. Detectives hunting for Damilola Taylor's killer plan a further news conference this morning. A teenager arrested as part of the inquiry was freed on police bail yesterday. He was the 13th suspect to be questioned about last month's stabbing. Record road congestion is forecast as the Christmas getaway peaks during a continued crisis on the privatised railways. Sadly, crowd control measures have been introduced because of growing anger among rail travellers. And not for the first time in Scotland, there's a wedding later today. You'll probably see something about it on TV later. Who knows, maybe even a line or two about it in tomorrow's newspapers. That's it from the news team. Have a very Merry Christmas. For the last time, it's over to Simon.
Thank you very much, Jasmine. Awesome. Happy Christmas to you, Jasmine. Quick look at today then. Well, this morning, dry and cold generally. Eastern Britain might see a bit of drizzle through the fog. Elsewhere in the west, you may see a couple of sunny breaks. Southwest rain. North of Scotland, a little bit of sleet. And maybe a bright spell in Northern Ireland. That's all from me. Have a happy Christmas. See you later.
Shows will feature Joe Pasquale, Phil Jupiter, Les Dennis, Louis Theroux, Natalie Gessley, Michael Ball, Jay Horrocks, Richie Blackwood,
and more from Richard Bacon and Donna Eyre.
Yes, right now, Harry, take it away.
Well, Madonna and Guy's Scottish wedding platter will be served up to the superstars that matter. Gwyneth Paltrow, Brad Pitt, and little George Clooney will all sit for a slap up meal of Mars Bar's fried in batter. The lottery did fail. Branson cast and shouted Damelot, but to be quite too fair to Camelot, all they had to do was mention Virgin Rail.